So in this lecture now we're going to talk about an application of electrochemistry and we're going to relate KSP or the solubility product constant with cell potential. So we're going to consider finding the unknown cell potential or the half reaction potential for the reduction of palladium to hydroxide to palladium. And we're given some information about the solubility product of palladium hydroxide in aqueous solution. And we're also given the reduction potential of free palladium 2 to palladium 0. So we'll start by defining this KSP process. And you may have seen this previously in a general chemistry course, but KSP is, as I mentioned, the solubility product constant. And KSP is used to describe how soluble a given solid is in aqueous solution. So, for compounds such as palladium hydroxide that are not very soluble in aqueous solution, there are small KSP values. You'll notice that this is 3 times 10 to the negative 28, which is infinitely small. So the process where palladium hydroxide dissolves in water is the following, where palladium hydroxide can dissociate into palladium 2, which was aqueous. Of course, palladium hydroxide was an insoluble solid before dissolution. And then we produce 2 hydroxide ions per palladium. Those are also aqueous. And KSP is simply the equilibrium constant. Like all other equilibrium constants, we write it as the aqueous or gaseous products divided by reactants. So here we're going to ignore palladium solid and simply write it as palladium 2 concentration multiplied by hydroxide squared. So the product of palladium and hydroxide concentration squared is going to give this KSP value of 3 times 10 to the negative 28. So only a small concentration of palladium and hydroxide will result from this dissolution. Or this compound is mostly insoluble in water because KSP is so small. So we can relate this process or the equilibrium constant to the cell potential. And we want to find the cell potential for the reduction of palladium hydroxide, where it accepts 2 electrons. So that value is unknown. But we do know one cell potential for palladium, where it's palladium 2 becoming palladium 0. So palladium 2, if aqueous, can accept 2 electrons and be reduced to palladium 0 in the solid metallic form. And that's said to have a potential of 0.195 volts. Now, what we're looking to find here is the cell potential for palladium hydroxide, allowing palladium to then accept electrons and become palladium 0 and 2 hydroxides do not undergo redox. They simply become aqueous ions. This potential is unknown. So we can use Hess's law type ideas because we're dealing with these thermodynamic parameters, right? Equilibrium constant, cell potential, and free energy change. that can all be summed together because they are describing state functions, or they are state functions. And if we think about the standard free energy change, delta G, we know that this is equal to both negative RT times natural log of the equilibrium constant, in this case, the KSP equilibrium constant. And that's also equal to negative moles of electrons multiplied by Faraday's constant multiplied by the standard potential. So we're given a KSP, and we can use that KSP to find the cell potential. So you can set those equal to one another and say that E standard is equal to RT ln of KSP all divided by NF. So I'm going to solve for that here. So we're doing this reaction. We'll assume that the temperature is at 298. And the gas constant 8.314 multiplied by the temperature 298 multiplied by natural log of the KSP all divided by the number of moles of electrons transferred. So number of moles of electrons when palladium hydroxide is reduced, or when palladium is reduced, is 2. Multiplied by Faraday's constant. So if you plug this in, you're going to get the cell potential that's associated simply with the dissolution of palladium hydroxide in solution. So here we get that E cell is equal to negative 0.814 volts. So let's think about what that means, right? This is with respect to the dissolution of palladium. So we know that palladium hydroxide is sparingly soluble in water. And this KSP process produces palladium 2 hydroxide and 2 hydroxide aqueous products. And the E value we just solved for is negative 0.184 volts. And we also know, as previously written, and we were given that palladium 2, if it's free in solution, not paired with hydroxide, then that has the potential to reduce to palladium 0, and that potential is 0.915 volts. So if we take these two reactions that we now know potentials for, A and B, and we add them together, right, we can use Hess's law type idea, and we can combine the potentials to find the potential for a third unknown reaction. So if you add them together, the hydroxide cancels out. Sorry, the hydroxide is remaining as a product, excuse me. Palladium 2 cancels out. and we get net reaction C for palladium hydroxide and two electrons combining these reactants, giving palladium zero and two free hydroxide products. And the E cell for this half reaction should be the addition of the two above for reactions A and B, or 0.195 volts plus negative 0.814 volts, or E is 0.101 volts. So once again, just a recap, right? The solubility product tells us about how soluble these sparingly soluble compounds are in solution. And it says that palladium hydroxide, for the most part, sits at the bottom of the solution and does not dissolve. But when it does, to a slight amount, the multiplication of palladium and hydroxide squared will give the KSP. From that KSP, we can find the potential by relating the standard potential with the standard free energy change, and that relates to the equilibrium constant. So all these thermodynamic parameters can be related and then combined as necessary. So after we find that standard potential, we can simply sum that reaction together, the KSP reaction, that is, with the reduction we were given for free palladium. And summing those two together allows the palladium two to cross out so that it's not observed in this net reaction for the reduction of palladium hydroxide. So you have to combine the KSP, or the dissolution potential, along with the free palladium reduction potential to get the net reduction potential for palladium hydroxide. So for more practice with KSP and for equilibrium, free energy, and other voltage type problems, you can visit either unit 4 of my electrochemistry portion in the analytical course guide. That's at chemguides.com. And also at chemguides.com, you will find the electrochemistry unit for general chemistry. Both of them are available there.